Hello friends, so today we will see what do you mean by a linear transformations and why do we need the notion of vector spaces while studying linear transformations. Then we will see what does the word linear means over here. Is this the same meaning that you have seen in your high school about the linear function? That also we will see. Then I will tell you some examples and non-examples of a linear transformation so that the funda will be clear to you. And I will give you some hints, condition apply, that if you know some basic things, then by simply looking at the function, 99% of the times, you can say whether it is a linear or it's not a linear transformation. So let's see this concept one by one. So suppose if you have a function t from one vector space to another vector space, your v and w are vector space over real numbers. If you are comfortable with vector spaces over complex numbers or over fields, that's also fine, but I will restrict myself to real numbers. So v and w are vector spaces over real numbers. Okay, so now when I will call this function to be a linear transformation, so first of all, it's a function. It will take a vector from a v vector space and output is what? T of v bar, and this is in your w vector space. Okay, now suppose this is one set, this is your vector space V and this is your vector space W. Now I will say that T is a linear transformation provided it satisfies two properties. So let's see them one by one. So what is the first one? Suppose if you take two vectors from here, suppose if you take X bar and Y bar, so these are two vectors in your vector space V, you look at its image under T. So suppose this is your T of X bar, and suppose y bar goes to somewhere here. So suppose this is your t of y bar. Fine. Now you add your x bar and y bar. So suppose this is your x bar plus y bar. Now one can ask a question. If you have a set, you take two vectors from that set. When you add these two vectors, will this addition again fall into the same set? That's not true always, but we are in a vector space. So what does vector space says? If you take two vector from a set, you add them up, then their addition will again fall into the same set. It won't go outside. So x plus y will not lie outside the V. It will be inside V. So that's where we are using V as a vector space. Here, Tx is in W, T of y is in W. So definitely your T of x bar plus T of y bar will also be in W, because again W is a vector space. Okay, and you have x plus y over here, you look at its image, it is something t of x bar plus y bar. Okay, and what is the first property for linear transformation? When these two things are equal. So when your t of x bar plus y bar is equal to t of x bar plus t of y bar, so that's the first thing. You look at the image of x bar plus y bar, that should be same as t of x bar plus t of y bar. That means your t goes inside. So that's the first property for a linear transformation to satisfy. And this is called as a vector addition property. Okay. Now let's go for the next property, which is called as a scalar multiplication property. Okay. So let me again erase all this thing. And again, let's try to see the same way. Do we need vector space for the second property? Answer is yes. So you have a W vector space, you have a V vector space, you take X bar over here, you look at its image, say T of X bar. Now you take any alpha, a real number, you take any scalar. Now you look alpha times X bar. Will this lie inside the set or outside the set? It will lie inside the set only. Why? Because it's a vector space, right? So if you take a vector from a set, you take a scalar, you multiply. This scalar multiplication will again fall into the same set. So that's why alpha into x bar is again in the same set. You look at the image of this, which is t of alpha x bar. Now tx is over here. When you multiply this by alpha, suppose somewhere over here, then alpha into tx bar will also be in the set, because w is a vector space. And when these two things are equal, that is your second property, which is alpha into t of x bar. So this is called as a scalar multiplication property for the function t. So in general, you must have seen these two properties or the very standard definition that if you have a function from one vector space to another vector space, then you call your T to be a linear map if T of x bar plus y bar is equal to T of x bar plus T of y bar and T of alpha into x bar is alpha into T of x bar, where your x bar comma y bar is a vector in V, your alpha is a scalar. For simplicity, I am taking as a real number. So when a function satisfies these two properties, then such a function is called as a linear transformation. Well, some authors combine these two properties. So what they do is they write T of alpha x bar plus y bar is equal to alpha into T of x bar plus T of y bar. So here scalar multiplication property is also getting satisfied and vector addition is also getting satisfied. So either you verify them separately or you verify them at one shot. Both is okay. So that's about the linear transformation. Now let's see why the word linear. What does the word linear means over here? So let's start with an example. Suppose if I give you a function from set of real numbers to set of real numbers, and you take any x over here and you define f of x as say 3x plus 1. Is this a linear function? Like if you recall your high school fundas or high school concept, you will say, oh, degree of x is 1. So yes, this is a linear function. It's a linear function, no doubt. Is this a linear transformation or a linear map? Answer is no. Why? Because if you try to see what is f of x plus y, is this equal to f of x plus f of y? Okay, let us check this. Is this equal to f of x plus f of y? Answer is no. Why? Because what is f of x plus y? It is nothing but 3 times x plus y plus 1, which is 3x plus 3y plus 1. What is f of x? Your f of x is 3x plus 1. What is f of y? It is 3y plus 1. And when you add fx plus fy, what the addition will be? It will be 3x plus 3y plus 2. So this quantity is not equal to this quantity. So this is a linear function because you will say the degree of x is 1. But yeah, in that way it's okay. But as a linear transformation, this is not a linear function. This is not a linear map or this is not a linear transformation. Okay, such transformations, when you study higher mathematics, these are called as affine transformations. So such functions, or if you have say f of x, you take ax plus b, where b is a non-zero constant, then this is not a linear map or linear transformation, but such kind of transformations are called as affine transformations. Okay, so simply saying that okay, the degree is 1, therefore it has to be a linear transformation, that's the wrong thing to say. Okay, so keep this point in mind. Linear function are not linear transformation always. Okay, but yeah, if you remove this 1, if you simply take fx equal to 3x, then yes, this will work as it's a linear function as well as this is a linear transformation. Just give a shot, verify that this is a linear map or the linear transformation. Okay, so what does linear means over here? So if you have a function which, what is this? This is nothing but a linear combination, right? If you recall linear combination, if you have two vectors, say v1 and v2, what is linear combination of v1 and v2? It is c1 v1 plus c2 v2. So that's the linear combination. So you take a linear combination of vector. If your t goes inside, or we say that if your T preserves the linear combination, this is called as preserverance. So if your T preserves the linear combination, then we call such a function to be a linear transformation. So there are two ways to say what do you mean by linear transformation. Like some young kid who is studying linear algebra, he will say if T of x plus y is Tx plus Ty and T of alpha x is alpha into Tx, then we call it as a linear transformation. But once you grow old or once you have a maturity in that subject, then how he will define linear transformation? He will say a function that satisfies or a function that preserves linear combination is called as a linear transformation. So if you want to be a cool, sometimes behave a cool mathematical dude, what you can see is a function that preserves linear combination is called as a linear transformation. So yeah, that is the meaning of linear over here. It preserves linear combination. Now let's go towards some examples, and I will tell you that by looking at the example, can you see whether it is linear or not linear? So the first example, if you recall, what was thing we wrote? We wrote f of x equal to 3x plus 1. And this was not a linear transformation because this one was creating a problem. And what I told you later, if you remove that one, if you take f of x equal to 3x, then this is a linear transformation, right? Because what is f of alpha x plus y? It is 3 times alpha x plus y. This is nothing but alpha into 3x plus 3y. So this is alpha into fx plus fy. So cool, this is a linear transformation, and as we saw that this is not a linear transformation. So the first hint, whenever you see constant in the picture or in the function, it will never non-zero constant. So whenever you have a constant in the picture, that function will never ever be a linear transformation. Okay, so that's the first hint that one should keep in mind. Whenever you see a constant, it's never a linear transformation. Okay, so suppose now let me give you another example. Suppose if you have R3 to R2, okay, both are real vector spaces. So suppose if you take, say, a vector from R3, say x, y, z, all these are real number, it is going to say x plus y, y plus z plus pi. Now I will ask you a question, is this a linear transformation? In 1 second you will say, no, it's not a linear transformation, not more than 1 second. Why? Because you know that there is a non-zero constant in the picture. So because of this non-zero constant, although the degree is 1 everywhere, but because of this non-zero constant, it won't be a linear transformation. And you can verify, what is f of, you take x1, y1, z1 plus x2, y2, z2. Now what is the first thing you do? You add inside the things. So you have x1 plus x2, y1 plus y2, z1 plus z2. And what is f of this? It is nothing but you add first two components. So x1 plus x2 plus y1 plus y2. And here you add last two components and you add pi. y1 plus y2 plus z1 plus z2 plus pi. So this is the image of f of one vector plus another vector. Now what you do is you find f of x1, y1, z1 plus f of x2, y2, z2. There what will happen is, here you will have 2 pi in the picture because you are adding pi plus pi. So when you add, you will have 2 pi into the picture. You try to find f of x1, y1, z1. You find f of x2, y2, z2. You add them up. You will get 2 pi into the picture. If you are not getting, and if you are getting stuck at some of the step, you can ask me in the comment section. I will definitely, or one of my viewers will definitely reply. Okay. So therefore, by looking at the constant straight away within a second, you will say that it's not a linear transformation. But what if I remove pi? Then yes, since all the degree is 1 and there is no constant over here, therefore yes, it's a linear transformation. You try to verify this. If you don't get, you can ask me, or let me do this one example for you. So here if you observe t of, I am doing at a one shot, okay, so alpha of t, a vector plus another vector. So you first simplify inside. So this is what you have, alpha x1 plus x2, alpha y1 plus y2, alpha z1 plus z2. Now what is t of this? The first thing is you add first two components, and here you add second and third component. From first and third, you take out alpha common. And for second and fourth, there is no alpha. And this is nothing but alpha t of first vector plus t of second vector. So therefore, this is a linear transformation. You can pause the video and convince yourself. That's not an issue. Let's go for another example. Now let me give you another hint. So suppose if you have a function, say R2 to say R4. Suppose your xy goes to xy, x plus y, xy. So this is an element of R4. Now question is this a linear map? Now here is the second hint. There is no constant over here. The degree is 1, 1, 1, 1, but here the degree is 2. Like this is a binomial over here. It's not a monomial. So whenever you have a product of variables in the picture, it's never ever a linear transformation. Whenever you see product, it will never be a linear transformation. So once you see this example, within 1 second, you have to conclude, oh, there is a product, it's not a linear transformation. You are free. Product of not a number in a variable, okay? Product of variables is not a transformation. And if I write, suppose if I write x minus y, then yes, it's a linear transformation because no constants, no product, good. What if I give you, suppose, t from say r to r? So suppose your xy goes to sine of x plus y. What do you think over here? So will this be a linear map? Answer is no, because we know that sine of a plus b is not equal to sine a plus sine b. So sine is not a linear map. Therefore, even this will not be a linear map. So whenever you have trigonometry, sine, cos, cot, tan, cot, cosec, sec, so then it's not a linear map. Constants, non-zero constants, not a linear map. Product, not a linear map. Again, if the degree, suppose instead of this, if I give you x square, y, x plus y, x minus y, will this be a linear map? No, because x square means what? X into x. It's the product of variable. So whenever the degree is also not 1, it's never ever. Whenever the degree becomes more than 1, it is never ever a linear transformation. Okay, now let me take one last set of examples. Suppose if you in the world of matrices, MNR to say MNR, matrices to matrices, A is going to A square. Is this a linear map? Straight away, answer is no, because of the square over here. You know that A plus B square, we know that A plus B square is not equal to A square plus B square. So it's not a linear map. Obviously, degree is bigger than 1, straight away no. Okay, do you know what is A plus B square? I have recorded one lecture in my matrices playlist. Have a look, you will get the answer over there. Okay, cool, so this is not there. Okay, but suppose if I take from world of matrices to world of symmetric matrices. So what is SM? Symmetric matrices of order n. So what I'm defining? I'm defining a map. A is going to A plus A transpose. First of all, we have to make sure that this is a well-defined map. That means the output, this should be a symmetric matrix. Then only this will fall into this set SM. But is this symmetric? Yes. You take a transpose of this, you get the same thing. So this is a well-defined map. Okay, now is this a linear map? Yes. What is T of alpha A plus B? You check it out. This is alpha A plus B plus alpha A plus B transpose. And this is nothing but alpha A plus B transpose behaves in a nice way. It comes outside. It comes inside. And alpha transpose is alpha only. So you have alpha into A plus A transpose plus B plus B transpose, which is nothing but alpha into TA plus TB. So therefore this is a linear map and this is a well-defined map. Okay, so yeah, that was about linearity. Now let me give you some homework problems. So these are the 4 homework problems. You have to tell me whether they are linear or not. Only one thing for this map, SK means skew symmetric matrices of order n cross n. Okay, so we have to first make sure that this is a well-defined map. That means this A minus A transpose should be here. That means you need to show that A minus A transpose is a skew symmetric matrix. That is called as well-definedness. And then you have to tell whether it is a linear map or not a linear map. So in the answer, you have to tell me whether first linear, non-linear, second, third, fourth, linear or non-linear. And if you have any function in which you are having a doubt whether it's a linear or not, then also you can ask me in the comment section. I will happy to answer that. So I hope you got the notion of linear transformation. If yes, do not forget to like, share and subscribe. Thank you.